This video is a comprehensive guide on the taxation of cryptocurrencies in Canada. We're going to go through a ton of details. We're going to talk about how they're taxed, why they're taxed. We're going to talk about the difference between business income tax and also capital gains. And I'm also going to support all of this information with a ton of examples so you guys have a genuine understanding as to how all this is going to work. This is specific for those of you in Canada. This is not going to apply if you're in the US, but nonetheless, there is going to be a lot of information in this video that you guys are going to find useful. In the description below, I'm also going to give you some extra resources when it comes to tax rates and also when it comes to the CRA or the Canada Revenue Agency's information when it comes to cryptos. And I'm going to make sure that you have all the information that you need to approach this tax season in the most efficient manner. Folks, let's not beat around the bush. Let's get straight into the video. There are going to be over a dozen timestamps on this video, and I put that in place to help you guys better navigate. We're going to start off with some of the basic information, then we'll talk about some examples, and then finally at the end, I'm going to address some of the most common questions that I've been getting when it comes to taxation of cryptos in Canada. Keep in mind, guys, I'm not a tax professional. I'm not an accountant. I'm literally just some bald Arab guy that's talking to you guys on YouTube. This video is strictly for entertainment purposes. With a lot of folks making a ton of money and also losing a ton of money in the cryptocurrency space, the question of how all of this is going to be taxed probably has a lot of you guys confused. It's really important to mention that everything that I'm going to tell you in today's video is not speculation. It's not my opinion. This is coming directly from the CRA, the Canada Revenue Agency. Let's start off with what is a cryptocurrency. A cryptocurrency is simply a digital asset. Cryptocurrencies operate independently from a central bank or government, and that's why they've become so appealing to a lot of investors and also traders. It's really important to understand that the CRA treats cryptocurrencies as a commodity. It's not treated as a currency like the Canadian dollar is, for example. So when it comes to how it's taxed like a commodity, which is really important. Any income or losses from the taxation of a commodity is either treated as a business income or capital gains income. This distinction is incredibly important because ultimately it is going to impact how much tax you actually pay. And everyone's situation is going to be very, very different, so it's important for you to understand the basics of this. Key difference, business income is 100% taxable, and capital gains is only 50% taxable. So obviously, the taxation on capital gains is much better because you ultimately pay less tax. Don't stress, I am going to help you guys figure out whether or not you're going to be taxed as business income or as a capital gain. If you hold more than one cryptocurrency, each one of those is going to be taxed separately from the other. Because based on the CRA's guidelines, each digital asset needs to be evaluated separately. So your Bitcoin holdings is going to be treated separately from your Ethereum holdings, for example. Now that we're done the introduction, let's talk about reporting business income or capital gains from the disposition of a cryptocurrency. Disposition is a really simple term for selling. Disposition also includes transferring, exchanging, or gifting. All of these are considered taxable events. What's really important for you guys to understand too is if you hold cryptocurrencies, that is not taxable. You guys could literally buy $1 billion worth of Bitcoin and that is not considered a taxable event. It's only a taxable event, again, if you sell, transfer, or exchange or gift cryptocurrencies. Ultimately, what matters are your profits and losses from buying or selling cryptocurrencies. Holding on to cryptos is not going to trigger a taxable event. So let's start off with some very simple examples of what triggers a taxable event when it comes to cryptocurrencies. Number one, if you sell or make a gift of a cryptocurrency, if you buy one Bitcoin for $5,000 and then you later sell it for $10,000, you've earned a taxable profit of $5,000. But if the price of Bitcoin drops and you sell it for $3,000 instead, you can treat that $2,000 loss as a tax deductible loss, either as a business loss or as a capital gains loss based on the circumstance. And of course, I am going to go into detail here in just a second. In very simple terms, anytime you make a profit or a loss, that is considered a taxable event. Holding crypto is not a taxable event. The second example of a taxable event is if you trade or exchange cryptocurrency, including disposing one of the cryptocurrency to get another cryptocurrency. For example, you have one Bitcoin in a crypto wallet, but you want to cash in and use the funds to help cover some unexpected expenses. You trade your Bitcoin for $10,000 and transfer the funds to your bank account. The dollar value of your crypto at the time that you trade it, in this case, the $10,000 is subject to a tax event. Let me offer you a more detailed example. Say you have one Bitcoin that's valued at $10,000. But you think that the value will go down and you would rather invest in Ethereum, for example. You find a buyer who's more optimistic about the future of Bitcoin, and the two of you agree to exchange your single Bitcoin for 26.88 of his or hers Ethereum. Let's say, for example, that one Ether at that time cost around $1,500. This is going to total around $40,320. Remember, we're taking on 26.88 Ethereum at a cost of $1,500. That puts us at a total of $40,320. By giving $10,000 worth of Bitcoin in return for around $40,320 of Ethereum, you've technically made a total of around $30,320. Now, of course, it doesn't matter what the currency is. It does depend on what type of currency that you're using, whether it's Canadian dollars or USD. But that difference or that profit is considered a taxable event. And don't worry if that example doesn't make any sense. I have a lot more examples, so this is going to make sense to you guys by the end of this video. The third way that a taxable event could be triggered is if you convert cryptocurrency to a government-issued currency like the Canadian dollar or like the US dollar. For example, a couple of months ago, you bought one Bitcoin for $5,000. A couple of months later, you decided, listen, I want to exchange that Bitcoin and switch it over to the Canadian dollar, and I want to send it to my bank account. When you decided to exchange or switch over that Bitcoin, let's say that the value of Bitcoin at that time was worth $10,000. You've made a profit of $5,000, right? Because you originally bought the Bitcoin for $5,000. The Bitcoin at the time of you converting the Bitcoin was around $10,000. So you've made a profit of $5,000. That $5,000 is going to be taxable. The fourth way that a taxable event can be triggered is using cryptocurrencies to buy goods or services. The CRA provides us with a great example here. Let's say that you run a retail and repair shop and you've decided to begin accepting Bitcoin as a payment. A customer buys a $3,000 home entertainment system and pays with Bitcoin. Because cryptocurrency isn't recognized as a legal tender, remember, it's recognized as a commodity, the CRA views a transaction like this as a bartering. And now, as the owner of the shop, because no legal tender was exchanged, you must declare the $3,000 as part of your business income, which is completely taxable. Again, because you accepted Bitcoin and you did not accept the Canadian dollar, it is considered a fully taxable event under business income. And now that we've established some of the taxable events when it comes to cryptocurrencies, let's talk about whether or not that profit or loss is considered to be business income or capital gains. But first and foremost, why does that even matter? From a tax perspective, as we talked about previously, there is a big difference between capital gains and business income. If you report your profits as taxable gains, they're only 50% taxable. So only 50% of your profits are going to be taxable. So it's a far better way to be taxed because you pay less tax. Conversely, if you report your profits as business income, they are fully taxable. That is the key distinguishing factor between business income and capital gains income. Let me give you an example of a capital gains taxable event, okay? So let's say that you buy $25,000 worth of Bitcoin and you paid a transaction fee of around $20. A lot of exchanges that you guys are using to buy cryptos do charge you a small commission. So let's say for the sake of argument that it's around $20. So what you have to do is you have to get your adjusted cost basis or how much that transaction cost you. And then you would add all those together and then we can figure out how much you're going to be taxed. This is how the math is going to work. So you have $25,000. And then you have the $20 in commission or fees. That puts your total cost, or in other words, total adjusted cost, at $25,020. That's how much the transaction has cost you. If you're using an exchange that does not charge commissions or fees, then just stick with the $25,000. And again, this is just an example. So let's say that the value of the Bitcoin goes up and you sell your coin for $36,000. Your total capital gains is the selling price minus your adjusted cost basis, or how much the transaction originally cost you. And you are only taxed on 50% of this gain. So $36,000 is what you sold the Bitcoin for. $25,020 is your adjusted cost basis, or how much the original transaction cost you. That puts you at a profit of around $10,980. That's your total gain. Because it's a capital gain and you're only taxed 50% on capital gains, only 50% of this $10,980 is susceptible to taxes. So we divide this by two, or in other words, 50%. That puts you at $5,490, which is considered to be a taxable capital gain. The remainder of that amount is tax-free, which is awesome. So your taxable profit on the sale is $5,490, which would be added to the rest of your income and taxed accordingly by the CRA. The other half of your capital gains, also $5,490, can be pocketed tax-free. That was an example of a capital gains. Now, how is business income going to be taxed? I'm gonna use the exact same example. Again, you buy $25,000 worth of Bitcoin. you're charged $20 for the fee, or in other words, a commission. That puts the total adjusted cost basis, or how much the transaction cost you, at $25,020. When it comes to tax season, if you sell that Bitcoin for $36,000, once again, the selling price is $36,000 minus what the transaction cost you, which is $25,020. That puts your total capital gain at $10,980. That amount is fully taxable. That is the biggest difference. So you're going to end up paying a lot more taxes on business income than you are with capital gains. I hope this point has come across. But how do we know if we're going to be taxed as a business income or as a capital gain? Let's get into some of the details. This is from the CRA directly. The following are common signs that you may be carrying on a business which is 100% taxable. First and foremost, you carry on activity for commercial reasons and in a commercially viable way. So you own a retail store, for example. You undertake activities in a business-like manner, which might include preparing a business model and acquiring capital assets or inventory. You promote a product or a service. Finally, this is really important. You show that you intend to make a profit, even if you are unlikely to do so in the short term. I'm really going to break this specific one down because it does apply to a lot of folks that are watching this video right now, specifically if you're someone that's day trading or if you're actively involved in cryptocurrency trading. Business activities normally involve some irregularity or a repetitive process, but each situation is going to be looked at differently from the CRA. Here are some examples of business income which is 100% taxable. Cryptocurrency mining, of course, cryptocurrency trading, and also cryptocurrency exchanges. There are some exclusions here, so let's take a second to really break these down. The question that you guys are probably wondering is day trading considered business income or capital gains? Day trading is typically considered business income and is 100% taxable. So how do you know that what you're doing is considered a day trading under the eyes of the CRA? There are a couple of factors for us to take a look at. Number one, the frequency of your transactions. If over a span of 12 months, you've only bought and sold cryptocurrencies 6 or 7 times, or maybe up to 30 times during the whole year, it's very difficult for the CRA to argue that you're operating under a business just because you haven't really done it that frequently. But if you're buying and selling cryptocurrencies a couple of times a day, then it's very obvious and it's very easy for the CRA to argue that you're operating under a business. Number two, the duration of your holdings. This is very, very significant. If you're someone that buys Bitcoin and you only hold onto it, you never trade or transact with it, it's going to be very difficult for the CRA to argue and say that, hey, this person is operating under the business because you're not trying to make a profit. You're basically just holding on as an investment. That's a key difference. But if you're someone that buys Bitcoin or Ethereum or Dogecoin, whatever it is, and you're out of that position within the next day, well, it's going to be very easy for them to argue that you're day trading. In other words, you're doing your best to make a profit. That is considered business income. But if you bought $50,000 worth of Bitcoin at the start of the year and it's worth around $500,000 right now, it's not going to be taxed as a business income because you bought once and you basically did nothing from that point. That amount was the same. You didn't transact, you didn't speculate, and you didn't day trade. So that amount is going to be taxed as a capital gains. Of course, I am going to talk and show you some examples of how this is going to break down too. Most importantly, your knowledge and experience of the stock market and how much time you spend on the activity. If you've taken courses on day trading or you're someone that's day traded for 10, 15 years of your whole life, then it's pretty obvious that your transactions are based on a business income. Most importantly, if you're someone that's involved in the space and you understand the space and you have connections and business connections, then it's going to be easy for the CRA to argue that you're operating under a business income. Most importantly, this is something that I'm going to add too. It depends on how big of a portion it is from your income. For example, if you're a doctor and you're making $300,000 a year from your operations as a doctor, if you only made $30,000 from, you know, trading cryptocurrencies, it's going to be difficult for the CRA to argue that this person is operating under a business because proportionally from your income, that gain or that profit that you've seen from day trading crypto is so small, it's hard for them to argue that you're operating under a business. Conversely, if you're someone that works at Starbucks, for example, and you make around $30,000 a year, and during that year, you made $150,000 from cryptocurrencies, well, guess what? It's very obvious. As a proportion of your income from work, then obviously you are operating under a business. So there are a lot of factors that come into play, whether or not it's going to be considered capital gains or if it's considered a business income. So in the case of the doctor that makes $300,000 a year and only made $20,000 trading crypto, his crypto gains are going to be considered a capital gain. But in the case of the person that's working at Starbucks, they're going to be considered a business income and their income is going to be fully taxable. Small difference, but it's something that I want you guys to appreciate. What's really important for you guys to appreciate, everyone's situation is going to be much different and much more complex. That's why it's very difficult for you to get a straightforward answer when it comes to how things are going to be taxed. For example, right here at the top, we said frequency of transactions. That's interesting because, for example, if you're someone that is very well off and you have a pretty solid income, let's say, for example, that every single day you buy $1,000 worth of Bitcoin, every single day, but you've never sold. Under the CRA, you're not going to be taxed as a business income, but rather a capital gain. You're going to be considered an investor. Why? Because you're not speculating and you're not day trading. You're not trying to make a profit during a short amount of time. Rather, you're just an investor that believes long-term in Bitcoin and you want to accumulate as many coins as possible. So while it does say that frequency of transactions matter, if you're someone that's an investor and you're buying Bitcoin or Ethereum or whatever it is constantly, it doesn't matter. It's still going to be considered a capital gain. So it's a small detail. I know it's slightly confusing, but really your intentions behind the transaction is ultimately what's going to matter the most. In really simple terms, if you're someone that's trying to make a profit for the short term, more than likely it's going to be taxed as a business income. If you're someone that's long term, it doesn't matter how many times that you buy, it's very likely going to be considered a capital gain when the time comes and you want to sell. For example, the fact that you have a high volume of trades won't mean you're in business if your long-term intention is to build up an investment portfolio. On the other hand, a single transaction could be considered a business income, especially if it was made in hopes of making a quick profit. So your intentions behind the transaction is going to make a big difference. Collectively, this reveals a pattern of activity that's consistent with either an investment or a business operation. So we've established if you're operating under a business, it's 100% taxable. But for most folks that are really just investing in Bitcoin, it's going to be taxed as a capital gain. And a capital gain, in summary, occurs when you earn money from selling or exchanging crypto that has increased in value. In Canada, you're only taxed 50% of the realized gains. The capital gains are realized when you dispose of an asset. And we talked about the disposition of an asset a couple minutes ago at the start of the video. You can also claim a capital loss when you lose money from selling or exchanging crypto that has gone down in value. For example, if you buy Bitcoin worth $10,000 and then you sell or spend it when it's valued at $20,000, you've realized a capital gain of $10,000. And since capital gains are only 50% taxed, you'll only be taxed on the $5,000. Generally, if disposing of cryptocurrency is part of the business, then the profits you make on the disposition or sale are considered business income and they're 100% taxable. Buying a cryptocurrency with the intention of making a quick profit, even if you do it once, can also be considered a business income. In other words, it's day trading. Now, if the sale of the cryptocurrency does not constitute carrying on a business and the amount it sells for is more than the original price, or the adjusted cost basis, again, adjusted cost basis is just what the original transaction cost you, then the taxpayer has realized a capital gain. And capital gains from the sale of cryptocurrency are generally included in income for the year, but only half of the capital gains is subject to tax. So let me break down some examples that the CRA has given us, which are really fantastic. For example, business income or loss. Now remember, business income is 100% taxable. Alice regularly buys and sells various types of cryptocurrencies, so it's very obvious that she's day trading. She pays close attention to the fluctuations in the value of cryptocurrencies and intends to profit from the fluctuations. Her activities are consistent with someone who's engaged in the business of day trading. Because if we rewind a couple minutes ago, remember how I told you guys factors that determine a day trading pattern include the frequency of transactions, the duration of your holdings, your knowledge and experience of the stock market, and how much time you spend on the activity. Now back to Alice. Her activities are consistent with someone who's engaged in the business of day trading. In 2017, Alice sold $240,000 worth of various cryptocurrencies, which she had originally purchased for $200,000. So her original cost on the transaction, or her adjusted cost basis, was $200,000. And when she sold, it was $240,000. So her net profit is $40,000. Since Alice is actively trading in cryptocurrency, which is a commercial activity or day trading business activity, she has to report business income of $40,000 on her income tax return, and it's going to be 100% taxable. What I'm also going to do for you guys in the description below, I'm going to give you a resource to show you what the tax rates are for a lot of the provinces that we have here in Canada. For example, in Ontario, and I know this table might be slightly confusing, but I'm going to do my best to explain it to you guys. It says the first $45,142, so up until $45,142, you pay around 20.05% of taxes. Anything above $45,142 up until $49,020, that amount is taxed 24.15%. You guys can go ahead and take a look at that resource to give you a better idea as to how much tax you'll pay on this if it's 100% taxable. Now, what's really interesting about this table as well, and this is why I really love it, when it comes to capital gains, look at the difference. Other income is 20.05% on the first 45,142. The capital gains, if you guys notice, is literally 50% of that amount because capital gains are only 50% taxable. You pay 50% less tax on capital gains. That's why you guys see the difference here. And the same thing, anything above 45,142 up until $49,020, you'll pay 24.15%. And if it's a capital gain, you basically pay half that amount. You can also pick the province that you're in so you have a better idea. Now, remember guys, this is not financial advice. I'm not an accountant, I'm not a tax lawyer. This is just for entertainment purposes. First example, we talked about business income or loss right here at the top. The second example is gonna be an example of a capital gain or a loss. Let's say that Tim found a deal on a living room set at an online vendor that accepts Bitcoin. Tim acquired $3,500 worth of Bitcoin to buy the furniture with. By the time that he bought the furniture and converted his remaining Bitcoin back into dollars, the value of Tim's Bitcoin had increased by $500. The gain realized by Tim was on account of capital, so it was a capital gain. Tim has to report $500 as a capital gain on his income tax return. However, because it's a capital gain, only 50% of that gain is going to be taxable. So he's only gonna have to pay taxes on $250 worth of that gain. Another example, just to stress the point of capital gains or capital losses. We talked about this example, but I'm gonna summarize it very quickly. You buy $25,000 worth of Bitcoin. There's a $20 commission. That puts your total cost of the transaction up around $25,020. Let's say that the price of Bitcoin goes up to $36,000, and then you sell it when it's at $36,000. So your selling price was $36,000, your original cost was $25,020, your total capital gain is $10,980. Since capital gains are only 50% taxable, you're only gonna have to pay tax on $5,490. The third and most important example is when you trade one type of cryptocurrency for another. And feel free to pause this portion of the video or rewind it so you can really understand this example. Let's say on July the 30th of 2018, Francis bought 100 units of Ethereum. Okay, so 100 units of Ethereum, which had a value of around $20,600. For this purchase, Francis used 2.5061 Bitcoin, which at the time were trading at $8,220 per unit on that specific day, or the equivalent of $20,600. Let's say that Francis originally bought those Bitcoins for $15,000 and then exchanged them for 100 units of Ethereum at a value of $20,600. Basically, that results in a capital gain of, let me break down the example here. So we know that he originally bought them for $15,000. And then when he switched them over or exchanged them, the value was around $20,600. That difference is considered to be a capital gain. So $5,600, which is the difference between the original cost and the selling price, is only taxable at 50%. So only $2,800 is a taxable gain on that specific transaction. So I bought them for $15,000. I sold them for $20,600. That difference of $5,600 is only 50% taxable under a capital gains tax. Therefore, I'm only gonna have to pay tax on $2,800. Let me give you a slightly different example here. Let's say, for example, that instead of the original cost being $15,000, instead the original cost was around $25,000. So when he exchanged them, it was around $20,600. So he originally bought them for $25,000. That's his adjusted cost basis. That's what the original transaction cost him. But when Francis decided to exchange them for 100 units of Ethereum, they were only worth around $20,600. In this case, he would have a capital loss because he bought them for $25,000. And when he exchanged them, it was only worth $20,600. So same thing, his adjusted cost basis was $25,000. When it came time to exchange, it was only worth $20,600. That means his capital loss is $4,400, and a capital loss is only 50% deductible. So that means that only $2,200 is considered to be a capital loss. And of course, guys, this example is to stress on the fact that this was a capital gain. This assumes that the cryptocurrency in question was held as an investment and not as a business trade or a day trade. If this transaction occurred in the course of conducting a business, the entire amount of $5,600 would need to be reported as an income in the first transaction, and the entire loss of $4,400 would be reported as a loss in the second one. Let's talk about a lot of you guys that are engaged in mining of Bitcoin or mining of cryptocurrencies. The income tax treatment for cryptocurrency miners is different depending on whether their activities are considered a personal activity, a hobby, or a business activity. This is going to be decided on a case-to-case basis, so there's no clear-cut answer to this question. But a hobby is generally undertaken for pleasure, entertainment, or enjoyment rather than for business reasons. But if a hobby is pursued in a sufficiently commercial and business-like way, it can be considered a business activity and will be taxed as such. So if you're someone that has a small mining rig and you're not making a ton of money from it, then you should be fine. It's probably going to be taxed as a capital gain. Of course, do consult your accountant. However, if you have 50 rigs and you have a whole operation dedicated to mining Bitcoin or Ethereum, for example, then obviously it's very likely to be taxed as a business income, which is 100% taxable. Folks, if you've gotten any value out of the video so far, a like is going to help me tremendously. It pumps this content out to the YouTube algorithm. This has been a ton of work, so I hope you guys appreciate it. Now, what do you need to keep records of? And this is a question that I get very, very often. Keeping books and records, and this comes directly from the CRA. Again, the resource is going to be down in the description if you guys want to see what the CRA says exactly about these things. It says, if you acquire by mining or otherwise, or dispose of cryptocurrencies, you have to keep records of your cryptocurrency transactions. For a lot of you that use online exchanges like Binance or Coinbase, all that information is going to be there, but it's always a good rule of thumb to have a physical note somewhere. If you have an Excel sheet, even if you want to write it down, for me, I keep a record of all my trades right here in this book. Here are some of the things that you have to keep in mind when it comes to this information. Of course, the CRA by law could require you up till 6 years of records. So they could go back 6 years and ask you for information about your transactions. So keep a record of up to 6 years. The date of the transaction is going to be very important. Receipts of purchase or transfer of the cryptocurrency is going to be very important too. The value of the cryptocurrency in Canadian dollars at the time of the transaction, the digital wallet records and cryptocurrency addresses, a description of the transaction and other parties, even if it's just their cryptocurrency address. Of course, exchange records, accounting and legal costs, and of course, the software costs related to managing your tax affairs. If you're someone that's operating under a business, a lot of these things, especially the cost of software and accounting and legal fees, is something that you want to keep a record of because you can use those as tax deductions. I'm not going to go into detail about those because we could really go down a deep rabbit hole. If you're someone that's mining, keep a record of the following: receipts for the purchase of cryptocurrency mining hardware, receipts to support your expenses and other records associated with the mining operations, like power costs, mining pool fields, hardware specifications, maintenance costs, and hardware operation time, and also mining pool details and records. Again, all of this is going to be used for tax deductions if you're operating under a business. So let's move on to some of the most common questions that a lot of folks have when it comes to cryptocurrencies. When is cryptocurrency not taxable? Hopefully at this point, you at least have a basic understanding of capital gains tax, business income tax, and when cryptocurrencies are taxable. But for the most part, you're taxed on money earned from investing in cryptocurrencies, not on cryptocurrency itself. So if you hold Bitcoin or Ethereum, that's never going to be a taxable event. So you don't have to pay taxes on crypto you're simply holding onto. But the moment that you dispose of crypto, whether that's a sale, trade, exchange, or even gifting crypto, that is considered a taxable event or a disposition in the eyes of the CRA. Of course, those gains are either considered a capital gains, which is 50% taxable, or a business income, which is 100% taxable. What if my cryptocurrency is lost or stolen? You may be able to claim a capital loss or a business loss if your crypto is permanently lost or stolen in some way. This includes losing evidence of ownership or losing an unreplaceable private key. However, if an item is replaceable, it likely won't qualify as a tax loss for tax purposes. This is something that you have to consult a tax lawyer about because the rules and regulations behind this are very complex and they're way out of the scope of this video. Now, the big thing, what if I fail or if I don't report any of my cryptocurrency activity? If you repeatedly fail to report $500 or more of your income to the CRA, you may end up being slapped with a penalty of 10% on the unreported amount, which is not going to be a big deal. But this applies to individuals, businesses, corporations, and trusts. But if this is a repeated failure, meaning a failure to report all your income more than once in a four-year period, either intentionally or by accident, you could be prosecuted, and in many times you get heavy fines and in some cases also jail time. Tax evasion is incredibly serious here in Canada. Like, you're better off selling drugs than you are evading taxes. You are not going to be taxed on holding cryptocurrencies. You're not going to be taxed on buying cryptocurrencies either. What do you do if you have multiple types of cryptocurrencies? If you have more than one type of cryptocurrency, so if you hold Bitcoin and Ethereum and Cardano, for example, you'll need to treat each type of cryptocurrency as a separate digital asset for tax purposes. This means all types of coins must be valued separately. For example, Bitcoin needs to be valued separately from Ethereum. Question that I get very often: I've traded on crypto exchanges outside of Canada. Will I need to pay foreign taxes? Now, this is possibly, again, make sure that you consult your tax professional or your accountant. You may have to pay income taxes in other countries as well as in Canada. However, many countries have tax treaties with Canada to prevent double taxation. The US, for example, has this treaty. So speak to a cryptocurrency tax specialist to find out exactly what the rules and exemptions are in this case. And how long do I need to keep my records? The CRA recommends keeping all tax records for at least 6 years after filing in case you get audited. Now, you will get audited if you aren't reporting a lot of your income or your transactions to the CRA. It's important for you guys to understand that a lot of these exchanges, in many cases, are forced to report to the CRA. So if the CRA already knows about a lot of your transactions and tax time comes into play, if they see a discrepancy, they are going to audit you, and it is a brutal process. You don't want to be in a position to get audited by the CRA because you're going to have to explain and show where you got every single cent that you have under your name. Avoid getting audited. Do the best you can to report all this efficiently. We're at the end of the video. Once again, guys, if you did get any value out of this, a like is going to help and support me tremendously. Thank you so much for your continued support, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have an awesome day.